Hello everyone. This video is the first one in a short series that I'm going to make, where I'm going to use data, statistics and Python to answer some of the questions that I often hear around the climbing walls. For example, how long will it take to climb my first 7A? Or is it easier to climb a 7A or V6 boulder or a 7A sport route? And does height really matter in climbing? And what about age? Does it matter if you start climbing when you're younger or when you're older? You can probably find many videos or articles trying to answer these questions with anecdotal evidence. But in these videos, I'm going to try a different approach. A few months ago, I came across a huge dump of data that was collected from the website 8a.nu. If you're not familiar with it, it's a climbing website where people keep logbooks of their climbs. These include things like the time, the grade, the number of attempts, and so on. The data that I found included more than 4 million climbing ascents recorded by something like 60,000 people. Since I love data and I love climbing, this is the perfect opportunity to combine my passions and answer once and for all some of the most common questions about climbing. The first thing that I want to analyze is the relationship between flush and redpoint. For those unfamiliar with climbing terms, to flush a route means climbing it on the first attempt, without faults or rest on the rope, using no other holds than the rock itself. To redpoint means climbing a route after having practiced the moves in any number of attempts. So the first question that I ask myself is, if you can flush, say, up to 6B, what grade can you climb at your limit on redpoint? And to answer these questions, I looked at all the individual users that are in the dataset and looked at their maximum grade that they climbed both on redpoint and on flush. For example, say that Bob and Alice both climbed up to 6E, but Bob flushed maximum a 6A, while Alice once flushed a 6B. We can say that both of them climb up to 6E, so if we take the average of their flush grade, we can say that if you climb up to 6E, you should be able to flush a 6A+, which is the average between 6A and 6B. If we do this with all the 60,000 users that are in the dataset and average all the possible grades that they climbed, we end up with this table. You can see that there are three different columns. We have max redpoint, max flush, and average flush, and you can go in into this table with any of the three. Say, for example, that you normally can flush up to 6E and you want to know what is the maximum redpoint that you can expect. If we go in through the second column, max flush, we can read the value of max redpoint, which is 7A. So if you're flushing up to 6E, you can expect to climb up to 7A. On the other hand, if you want to climb, say, 8A, you should be able to flush around 7B, 7B+. I also included a third column for the average flush. This can be interpreted as the grade that you normally flush consistently. When I began climbing, I started with indoor bouldering, but then slowly transitioned to outdoor sport. So I'm kind of in between the two. But some people are die-hard climbers or boulderers. And one of the questions that I often hear being asked most is, is it harder to climb a 7A sport route or a 7A or V6 boulder? To answer this question, we're going to use the information from the data that says when the users started climbing. This information, combined with the date of each ascent, allow us to calculate how many years it took for someone to achieve that specific grade for the very first time. And once we have the number of years, we can then create a bin chart. Basically, we simply count how many users managed to climb 7A in 1 year, how many users managed in 2 years, and so on and so on. And we can do this for both sport climbing and bouldering, and then compare the two bin charts to see which one is harder. The result of this procedure looks like this figure, and you can see that the two curves that we are obtaining are very, very similar. If bouldering 7A was harder than sport climbing, we should probably see more people taking longer times to achieve the grade. But the two curves show that most people take between 1 to 3 years to achieve the same grade, both in sport climbing and in bouldering, with some climbers taking up to 20 years. But of course, this doesn't take into account the people take breaks from climbing, or the people that, for example, started climbing 10 years ago, only started taking it seriously last year. So take these results with a pinch of salt. Anyway, if looking at curves and trying to eyeball similarities doesn't really sound scientific to you, I also try to run some proper statistical tests. If you want to know more details, you can read my full article in the description below. But I can tell you that the results showed that there is no statistically significant difference between the two, which in human terms, it basically means that it takes pretty much the same time to climb a 7A boulder or a 7A spot route. So both achievements are equally hard. Still talking about bouldering versus sport climbing, I was also curious about another question. Since I practice both disciplines, if I can climb a 7A route, what grade should I be expected to boulder? To answer these questions, I first separated data into men and women because there were some substantial differences. Then I picked all users that practiced both bouldering and sport climbing and picked the maximum grade that they ever climbed in each discipline. I then took the average of all these grades and I put them all in these curves that you can see on the screen. If you're not familiar with this kind of plot, let me explain you. On the horizontal axis, you have the maximum sport grade. You can see 6A, 6A+, and so on. On the vertical axis, you have the maximum bouldering grade. Again, 7A, 7B, and so on. The solid line represents the grade that each user climbed on average in both disciplines. If we pick 7A, for example, as a maximum sport grade, we can see that men that climb 7A maximum as the sport grade can boulder maximum between 6A plus and 7A, whereas women who sport climb around the same grade can boulder up to 6C. We can see that there is a trend here, which is if both men and women climb the same grade on sport climbing, on average, men tend to boulder slightly harder grades than women. And this difference seems to get smaller and smaller the harder the grade they climb. However, if we look at men and women who boulder the same grade, they tend to achieve pretty much the same grade when compared to sport climbing, which I find really interesting. Let's make a practical example just to better understand this. If Bob and Alice can both climb a 7A sport route, it's likely that Bob can also climb a 7A boulder, but Alice can only boulder up to 6E. However, if Bob and Alice can both boulder up to 7A, chances are they can both climb a route up to 7B. I know that this may sound confusing at first, but if you want to understand better and see more details about this analysis, you can find the full article that I wrote in the description below. Now, I don't want to make a super long video because I think there is only so much data that we can deal with in one sitting, so I'm going to end this one here. In the next video, we're going to look at grade progression and things like how many years does it take to climb a certain grade, or what is plateauing, and when statistics tell us that we'll see the first 10A. If you like this video, please like it and leave a comment below. It's really nice to see comments and it really motivates me to do more. If you don't want to see more of these videos, leave a comment with the current solution of the Wordle in the section below. Then I'll stop making videos. Thank you for watching.